root to enclosure, and I want to go through the matings, how to use mates again, because just to show you first of all what I do when I get a project. So I pull, I do this, I go like this, say whoops, okay, that's not good, and I do that, right? So that's the first thing. When you guys hand a project to me, I see what I can pull apart. I want to see if, like, for instance, this piece here, I'm trying to pull on it and nothing's happening. So I'm happy with that, especially since that's the first part of the project. Usually that's the part that you want everything else to go around. So I'm just going to control Z here just to put everything back together. Okay, so a lot of you are not mating, or if you are mating, it'll be, let's just get this one here and see if I can get this to, it'll be something like this. Oh, why is that gone? Oh, right. Okay, so what happened there is because I unmated it, it actually put this, I don't know if you can see, it's put my, if you look at the mouse at the bottom and then the part at the top, it's actually put the two way apart. So just get those get back together again. So there's something weird with this Hyper-V machine, as it slows SolidWorks down quite a bit. Okay, there we go. Right, so some of you will have mates in your parts, or what I've seen so far, you'll have some mates to your parts. So I can do something like this, which is obviously not what we want. So I want to see if I can run through this. So I'm going to just see if we can... suppress all of these and just start off with two. So I'm going to go to my mates, suppress. Okay, so assuming you brought a part in, oh, that hasn't actually suppressed, just make sure. All right, so assuming you've brought a part in, if you'd brought it in, yeah, so maybe this, let me just address this first. The first part that you drop in, when you drop it in, you'll normally drop it in using the tick mark. So let me bring a part in. Showing us all the parts. Okay, I don't think it really matters. Let's pull that in. Right, so I did show you that if you want to drop it in place, in the same place as what you created it, you'd click the tick mark, okay? So that's drop this part in. But when you drop a part in like that, if I right click on this in the feature tree, you'll see that it shows one, two, three, four, five, seventh button. This will either show float or fix. So if it shows float, it means it's fixed the item in place, which is not what we want for all of the features after the first one. So let me right click on that piece. You'll see that says float as well. So in other words, this is actually at the moment, well, I've just unfloated it, because if I right click, you'll see it says fix. So if I click on this, it'll fix it. If click on it, it'll float it. So if I float it, it means I can pull it around. All right, so I'm going to go back to Z. I'm going to right click and fix that. So we want this first one high. So say it again. Yes, I am. Is that Kyra? Was that Sid? Sid. Sorry, and Kyra, this isn't addressed at you, by the way, even though you did ask me earlier in the week. Okay, so, but it's not addressed at you. It's just to show, this is something I was going to deal with in any case. So Kyra sent me a file earlier in the week, or last week, to dealing with this very issue. Right, so that's Right, so let me just show you quickly. So what all the parts subsequent to the first part, generally, and I mean this isn't always the case, if you've created parts in place and you've created them in such a way that they fit together without using mates, which by the way is a like it's a requirement. If you work in an aviation environment, you may not use mates at all to ever connect things. You have to actually create them in such a way that when they fit together, you don't use any mates. They're already created in place. So that's quite a strict requirement. But be that as it may, you might have created something in such a way that if you put it in, you can just fix it in place. Mostly you wouldn't have, because that's more work. So one understands. So that's why the mates exist. So I'm going to float this. And the first thing I want to do is I want to get this part to rotate. So I can click on an edge, and I should be able to right click on this and then just drag it around. Okay, so I've just got it basically in position so that it's sitting the right way up. Okay, so the next thing I can do is click on one face, hold the shift button down, click on another face, and then you should get this dialog box coming. I usually select parallel straight away just to get everything lined up. All right, so that's parallel, but nothing else is fixing it. Then the other thing I do is, if the two parts are the same, are sort of going to be mated in some way in terms of their width, in other words, there's some sort of center line, I either use this command. I'll show you an easier way, but I'll show you the mating way first. So I'm holding the shift button down, I'm clicking on the faces, and then you should get, not doing it. If it's not doing it, then you have to go to mate. So you'll see it'll automatically mate according to the only command available, which is width. So you should get, if you do that properly, you should actually get something like this. I'm just going to select this little filter for faces so it's easier to select. Click one face, two faces, three faces, and at the end of this, right, there we go. So you should get the mate appearing at the bottom of this dialog box, and if it disappears, like if I move away, that's not going to do it, just hit the control button again close to where you were last time and it'll reappear. So there we go, I've mated those two. Now, in fact, that's not a mate that I do want. It's not the correct mate, as you can see, but I was just using it to show you what happens there. So I'm going to go into this mates thing here, click on this and delete it. Okay, what I really want is, I'm not sure if that should mate with that. No, it isn't. Okay, so I'm going to leave this as it is for now, because I'm going to use this to connect the two. So first thing I want to do is I want to mate that face to this hole. But because this is a part which was created as a step file, this feature is not a hole. I have to select the edge. So I'll hold the shift button down, and I should be able to now select the edge. There we go. And it'll give you concentric or tangent. We'll be able to lock it. So I want tangent. Sorry, is that right? Concentric. That was concentric. And you can see it's put it in place. Okay, so I can move this up and down and around, it seems. So it's got one connection. Now I want that face to mate with this face. So I'm holding the shift button down, and there my mates appear. I'm going to click coincident, but you can see it's put it the wrong way. So I go across to the left-hand side here, right-click on that coincident, and then flip mate alignment, and this will just flip that item. Okay, everyone happy so far? I'm assuming that's a yes. So now the quickest way to put more of these in is not to bring more of them in, but just to right click on this item and go to this third window, and there's a command here called copy with mates. And so then it'll give you this little button in the feature tree or in the property manager. Property manager, I always forget the names. There's a little button that you have to push on the left hand side, on the right hand side of the left hand. Next, and there it'll ask you which of the mates do you want to keep and which one, or which ones do you want to repeat and which ones do you want to keep the same. So I don't want to repeat the tangent, although tangent is not correct. Okay, before I do that, I must just correct that. Edit feature. So I'm going to select concentric instead. There we go, that's correct. Okay, so let's go back into this. What was I doing? Yes, copy with mates. Copy with mates. Click this little button. Say I don't want concentric, but I do want coincident. So now you'll see it'll actually place a new item on the board, and it's coincident with this face. And all I need to do now is select what the other mate is. And it says, yes, I like that. Right, and it'll immediately place another one. As soon as you press this OK button, it'll place another one in place. And so you can just keep going, saying, well, I want one there. And you can right click here and say OK. And then one more there. And I say right click. Sorry, OK, but right click OK. And if I don't want any more, then I just click that button, and I've got four of them in place already. I don't have to pull any of them in. It's pretty quick. Good so far. Right, so now I should be able to click on either this face or that face. Doesn't really matter. It's easier for me to click on that face. Hold the shift button down, click on this face, and say concentric. And you can see immediately that this base has now moved into place. So now I can move this up and down, but I cannot move it left to right or front to back. Okay. So I need to then I don't need to do any more. That's enough mates to keep it in place up and down. All I need to do now is to mate that face to that face, and it's done. So that's everything fixed. If I try and move this around, it just won't do it. And that piece won't do it, and that piece won't do it. Okay. Obviously, anytime you want, you can go to any one of these and you can suppress it so that you can do something with it if you need to. But that's basically what you're trying to achieve all the time. You're trying to make everything fixed in place, and then after it's fixed in place, if you need to move things around or change any of these, you can either suppress them or edit them or delete them. I'm just saving that. Seth is here. Okay. Sorry, I'm just going across to my other side. Seth, where's your name? P. Anyone else join the meeting? That's it, huh? Okay, any questions so far? Okay, so I think is that enough info for you to understand mates, or are there more things that you need to understand? I think let me go through one more. I think in particular maybe two more. Let's do the shroud and the shroud and the fascia. Where's the fascia now? Okay, so I'm actually just going to delete all of these. Right, so see what happened there is, once again, I'm not sure why this happens. I think it's got to do with the changing program. Fancy has actually disappeared. And I can't drag it for some strange reason. Okay, it is floating. So I'm just going to delete this. And then bring it in. So insert components, browse, Fancier. Okay, so here I don't want to click this because that's going to put it in the wrong place. So it's facing the wrong way. In fact, you can, let's bring that in again. I'm going to maximize this. Insert, where are we? Insert components. Okay, so before you place it, you can actually, if I can remember correctly, you can get, yes, yeah, you can get this little button at the bottom. You can actually get it to rotate. So X isn't correct. Let's see if I can, I can pull that up. Okay, there we go. So you can pull this button to where you need it to be. So I'm going to just keep doing that until it's sitting back where it was. And I want to rotate now. If you have a look here, the X corresponds with that button there, the Y with that axis there, the green one, and the Z with the blue one. So it's the Y one that I want to rotate it around. So I can just click that twice, and if you get used to doing this, you don't have to do any more placing. So once it's in place, you just click inside and it's in position. So that's a quicker way to locate it as you bring it in than pulling it in and then having to rotate it using that other method. So what I want to do here is the same as what I would do the other ones. I want these four ends to give me a width. Okay. Right, and so that's done that one. I want these to go width ways around. That one. One, two, three, four. Width. Okay, then I want that face and that face to be coincident. And if I've designed this correctly, then these two faces, the face of the base and the face of the shroud, where they meet here, should connect properly. So even though I've shown you that that's the mate to use, the mate I just used now, the coincident one here, that one there, I should have used a mate between that face, the connection of these two faces. But it's useful for me to do this, to see that they don't, that they actually do line up. You can see here I've got a bit of a problem. So, because there's an interference, which I shouldn't have. Okay. So far so good. Now this can move backwards and forwards, and so can this. So now I need to just decide what it is that I want to mate to what. So in this case, I want that. No, not the base. I want this PCB board to hit the back of that shroud like that. And then the only other thing I need to do is to mate. One of these faces to that face there. So here we've got an interesting situation in that most of the faces that you see on this fascia are not normal to anything because they are created using tapers. I might have a problem in getting that face to mate to this one, because this face here is upright and this face might not be. I think in this case we won't have a problem. I hope we do have a problem, because I want to show you how to solve it. Okay, look at that. Right, so it won't allow me to do coincident because there's some mismatching in geometry. So if I put parallel, it's not gonna help me. Perpendicular, tangent might work. Let's see, tangent does in fact work. But the reason why it wouldn't give me the coincidence is because the two faces didn't meet. So I think, but see, the problem that it's given me is that it's actually given me an overlap here. Right, so this is the sort of thing that I do when I'm mating things, is I just examine what's happening. And if I see a problem, I go straight away to evaluate and do this interference detection and calculate. And that's going to give me all of the parts. So if I don't want to do that, if I just want to know how these two parts interact, I can select them beforehand, interference detection, and it'll tell you that it's only selected two of the components. And so now I can calculate just the interference between those two, and you can see what those interferences are. So it's highlighted them in red. That's one, it's two, three, four. So some of this has to do with my modeling. And that's because, let's go out of here. It's going to delete this tangent. That's because what I did is, when I first gave you this model, I'd modeled these ribs to be in line with this bottom line. But I'd suddenly figured out later on that that's not a good idea. You actually need a distance between this top edge. Let's see if we can get the measurement tool in here. Not gonna do it. Anyway, between there, yeah, that's what I can do. Between there and there should be 0.9, and I'd actually made it 1 millimeter. So it's still at 1 millimeter. That's not correct. All right, never mind. That's the reason why this is now oversized compared to what you guys had to deal with, and why it's not mating. So I need to go and adjust that as well. So part of the mating thing is also just to check your design to see if it's fitting together. So how would we mate this? Either I have to choose a line at the top, an edge, with this face, and tangent. But that's also not quite going to do what I wanted to do, because it's still going to give me an interference. You can see there's still an interference here. Control Z. So the other thing to do is then to select some other face that you know is going to connect, which are these two. And here I don't really want them to meet exactly. I want them to meet at a small distance of, say, 0.15. And there's the gap that I'm looking for. And that gap specifically because I know that the geometry on this shroud doesn't match the geometry on this piece exactly, because of the way, because this is modeled using injection molding processes, and this is modeled using sheet metal, and they won't always meet exactly. I can go and fix it, but I don't know if it's worth it. This gap is going to exist in any case, in some way or another, so it's actually a good idea to have it in there. Oba King is also here. Let me just hop across. Okay, what else do I need to show you? Can any of you remember what else you had to deal with in is that someone that needs to be unmuted? Oh. Who's that? So, Gabriel, yeah, I hear you. And who else spoke there? Who's that? Huh? Ah, Wilson. Okay, thanks, Wilson. I'll mark you as present now. Gabriel, go ahead. Okay, I've got your question. Let me just quickly mark Wilson correct. Right, so you got two cylinders and you want them to meet. Okay, exactly as I've just done now. You want to model that quickly. Okay, I'm not sure if it's quite appropriate, but let's have a look quickly. So the top lane, so let's quickly create a sketch. $150, eh? That's how big your toilet roll is. Something like that. Okay, let's quickly make it into an assembly. Go up one. Call that TR. Okay, I'm going to put that in place. Right, so I'm going to save assembly as TR assembly. Something like that. Excuse the pun there. Let's bring another one of these in. So something like this. Is this what you're talking about? Side by side. Okay, so we're gonna make these two. And make those faces like that first, just so that so this one can move around and that one can't, because if I right click here, you can see that that's fixed, and if I right click here, you can see that's floating. So you want that one and that one to meet, like say, a millimeter apart. Well, there's two ways that I can think of straight away. One is just to go straight with distance. And then play with it so that you can go here, you can go to center to center. So if you know what your centers are, so what was mine? 150, eh? So if I say center to center, and if I say 150 times, what's 75? So it should be 151. 151. So that'll be one way. Does that make sense? Okay, so in fact, that should. Yes. Ah, you mean can this one stop going around and around? Yeah, you can actually fix it. See if I can remember how to do this. If you go back to this mate. There is a way of locking it in place so that it doesn't go. I don't know if it's in this command. There is lock rotation. Yeah, so that I don't have a quick way. I mean, the quickest way I would then do is I would then just get the planes if I could. To mate, it's my favorite. Oh, that's the one thing that I didn't show you last time. I need to go back to that. That's actually the other way of mating things. So one of my favorite ways of mating, and you'll find a lot of people who use these things a lot, is to use the planes. So where are we? So right plane, no, front plane. If I there are I've selected those two, and if I mate them as being coincident, they're now locked in place. Okay, so I can't move this around. can't move that around. So let's just, yeah. So it's something that I think I might have gone through before, but it is something that I think is super important. Is I'm going to just hide. No, wait. What I'm going to do is go like this. Isolate. Where are we? Isolate. Is isolate. Okay, so when you isolate something, it just hides everything nicely for you. When I bring this part in, this is something I should have done right from the beginning, is check, first of all, that the planes are aligned. So those two planes I've selected, they are aligned. This plane, and I'm holding the control button, those two are aligned, I'm happy with that. And the right plane and the right plane should also be aligned. If they aren't, let's make them not be aligned. Let's move this out of the way a bit. Okay, so if they aren't, and you find out that they aren't, so you go to like this, and you can see just visually that they aren't aligned, you can see that. And if you've brought this in as a fixed item, then just float it first. And once it's floated, select the two planes, go to mate, and it'll instantly select coincident. Although you could do other things, but you don't need to. So go like that. And do that with each plane. So top, top. Those two are doing it. And so here, as I select them, you'll see as I let go of the shift button, it gives me those alignments. Oops. Okay, looks like meeting is... Can you guys still hear me?